I am going to show you six proven ways that you can collect emails. I know a lot of people, especially when they're first starting their business, they don't understand the importance of collecting emails. I know I didn't. I started out green. I knew nothing about internet marketing or anything. So it's going to take me a little bit longer to, when you start seeing me making that $10,000 a month or whatever, you'll be the first to know. But one of the things that I've been passionate about that I didn't understand in the beginning was collecting emails, because that is where your sales happen. They do not happen when you just go post a Facebook ad or post on social media. People need to warm up to you, and you get to do that through your emails. And I know that's hard to understand. You probably need to hear it a few times like I did, because I kept thinking, I don't want to do email marketing, but it is so vital to your business. I don't care what business you're in. Think about Walmart or Target or Kohl's or wherever you shop. And you know, when you're up there checking out and they'll say, can I have your email? They're trying to put you on their email list, because then they're going to bombard you with their sales and all their coupons and things like that. You're not going to be like that. You're not going to be annoying, but that's what people do to get sales. And every once in a while you do click it and you do purchase something if you get a good coupon. So it's not about the coupons, it's about having that relationship. That's how I want you to look at it. So I'm going to show you six different ways you can collect emails. Now, first of all, you have to have a way to reach people. And what I mean by that is you have to have a social media platform that you're using, that you're reaching out to people. Mine is YouTube. I did not start out with YouTube. I started out using Facebook, and I like YouTube better. That's just my preference. But other people, you may be on Instagram right now. Maybe you're new, you haven't really started, and you love Instagram. Then I suggest you use Instagram, because I don't want you to waste your time trying to figure out a new platform when you could be using something familiar, building up other systems, and then maybe later when those systems are in place, then change over. That's kind of how I did it. I just went with Facebook because that's what I knew, and it was a good thing to do at the time. And then as I started building my business, I realized I wanted to go to YouTube. So find a way to reach people. Pick your platform and stick with one and really master it before you go to another one. Number two, you have to have a way to collect the emails. You have to have a place to put them. And so what you need is an autoresponder. I have an autoresponder link below. It's the one that I use, and you're welcome to check it out or go check out something out. That's not what this is about. We're not talking about autoresponders, but you do have to have one to collect emails. Now, let's go ahead and get started with number one. To collect emails, you can offer a captivating lead magnet. Now, what is that? That is when somebody gives you something for free in exchange you give them their email. And here's an example. It says a cheat sheet for writing blog posts. So let's say you're into writing blogs. Somebody's offering a cheat sheet. You're like, hey, I'll take it for free. I'll give them my email, collect the cheat sheet. Now, you can start getting that person's email. You can unsubscribe anytime you want, and people can do that with your list. So put yourself out there. If people want to follow you, they'll follow you. And if they don't want to, they don't have to. But you're offering something for free. Now, I have a video that I made about lots of different lead magnets. So at the end of this video now, it's going to pop up at the end. So if you don't want to see the center and you want to go see that video, go to the end. And it's about lead magnets and different ones and how to make them. So hopefully that would be helpful for you. I do want to explain how that works with the lead magnet. Here's your source where you, remember I said you have to have a way to reach people. We call that traffic. So you could be pulling people in to your landing page or your opt-in page. You need a funnel, but what you're going to be doing is pulling people in from your Instagram or your Facebook or your YouTube or whatever. Maybe you only have one arrow, and that's okay, but some people have already built up 5 and 6 different resources. Don't compare yourself to them. You might have one little arrow, and you're going to lead them into a landing page, and you need a funnel or a website to do that. So let's say you lead them to your page, and then they give you their email and their address, and you send them the free thing. And that's basically how it happens. We call that an opt-in page or a squeeze page. And then they're on your email list and you start sending emails. And that's what these are. And this is the free thing that you send them. in that sales of a funnel, they will teach you how to do that. You know, when you set yourself up with a funnel. Yeah, there's lots of different tools that you need to start your business. I use ClickFunnels. I can put that link below if you want to check that out, but there's a lot of other ones out there as well. Most software tools will give you 14-day free trials. So check them out. If you're looking for something, check out two or three different options. Open them all up at the same time and compare and see which one best fits your needs. Don't always go by the cheapest price, just like with shopping. If you pay cheap, you're going to get cheap. And some of them start you out really cheap and then they'll hit you later. So look at the quality, what they serve, what the deliverability rates are and things like that, and then compare it. And you can see what people are using when they send you emails. You can even check it out that way. Here's some other examples of lead magnets. This one here is SEO. It's a little ebook. So people will make ebooks and they'll give those out for free. Here's a little checklist instead of a cheat list. And down here is four simple steps to hack your habits. Yeah, hack your habits. I knew it was about fitness. So, and then up here, somebody's giving out a coupon. Every single one of them are asking for an email. If you want lots and lots of different ideas, just Google it. There's a lot of articles written out there where they give you tons of ideas. So if you're in a certain niche, you can say lead magnets for fitness and just really narrow it in and get some other ideas from other people in your same niche. Number two, if you are using Facebook ads, some of you are a little bit more groomed, you're already doing this and you're just looking for ideas, you can ask for an email address in a Facebook ad. See this one down here? They're online accounting software for non-accountants, and it says right here, sign up. So what they're making you do is go through a bridge page, it kind of like an opt-in page, but they're having you sign up to get the information from them for whatever their product is. And they're just collecting your email. That's all you're doing. So be clever, put a really eye-catching page there, good copyright, get them to click that link and give you your email address. So that's another way that definitely works. Number three, you have a business page, right? You started a business, so you went into Facebook and you started a business page. Even if you're just starting to build it, go in there and put a little button. When you're building it, it'll say here, what kind of a button do you want? It's a call to action button on your page. And as you're building it, they'll ask you what you want to ask for. And some people send people to their messenger bot. Some people will send them to maybe their website. So find out where you want to send people, or to an opt-in page in a sales funnel, and people will hit that. Or it's just a call to action. You might just say, hey, give me your email. Another thing, I don't have a picture here, but if you set up a private group, don't just set up the private group. Make people sign up. I know that they can hit it and say, I want to join, but if you just approve everybody and don't get their email address, you're losing a lot of opportunity there. So make them answer three questions, and one of them say, hey, give me your email address. Another one, what would you like to get out of this group, or something like that, and then join the group, and you're collecting emails again, which is awesome, and that's what you want. Find creative ways to collect. That is the name of the game. You can buy solo ads. Now, there's a lot of controversy on this. I know people who say they only did it in the beginning and built their list up to about 2,000 and then stopped buying them. I hear people say, don't ever buy them. You're crazy. You're wasting your money. And then I hear the people in the middle that say, if you buy them, only buy like small amounts at a time. It's really up to you, but solo ads, somebody has a list maybe of 200,000 names and they're selling solo ads. I have a link below that you can go to and check it out. I also have videos about solo ads specifically, so you can, I could put that on there as well. But what people do is they go to that buyer and they say, I want to buy 100. And they might say, well, they're 55 cents a piece, so it'd be $55. And they'll run your ad through their list of 200,000 or maybe 10,000 or whatever. As soon as you get 100 clicks, they stop it. Some of them will give you 10 extra. Out of those 100, hopefully you'll get 30 or 40 people that will opt into your email list. And maybe out of that 30 or 40, you might get a couple sales. The reason I tell you not to put a lot of money out for one person is because every list is different, and you really, you can go in and read. Some of them will say, I really am into the health and industry business. That's where most of my people are. Some of them are into marketing. Pay attention to what their list specializes in, and then just buy a few at a time and see if you're getting sales. You don't want to waste a lot of money with a lot of names and emails that aren't ever going to produce anything. So be strategic in it when you do it. But hey, if you don't have anybody on your list, what do you got to lose? If you spend $200 or $300 to get some names, I don't think that's a bad thing, because it's better than only sending it to 7 or 8 people and building your list slow. At least you have, you know, a little bit more of a chance to get a sale. You can share your link on social media. I have an Instagram account. I am not a big active person on there, but I do have my profile link, which goes right back to my website. And I do have people that enter from there. So think about that on your profile. You have a chance to put one link. You can send them to a product, to a funnel. You can send them to a website, or you can send them to a bridge page if you're an affiliate marketer. So use those profiles on those other platforms. Now, you're probably thinking, but you just told me to only build one. What I meant was focus heavily on one and make that be your business, and then on the other platforms that you have, just go in and set up your profile and make sure you, if anybody happens across those other social media platforms, they can then come to your website or to your sales funnel. So definitely do that. What I did is I built my Instagram and my Twitter up. They're both up to maybe 6,000 followers. And then what I go in and periodically, you know, post things. But like, again, I definitely, YouTube is my number one platform where I definitely don't miss a beat. This is the sixth one. Ask your Facebook friends. I have seen people say, I just had a friend that I used to work with, and she has her own yoga company. She worked with me as a teacher, actually, and she quit and started her own yoga studio. And she's been doing it probably 5 or 6 years, and she just started an email sequence. And she told everybody, she said, hey, I'm starting this newsletter that I want to send out to everybody about health and fitness, and I would love it if you would join. And she's a friend, and it's something that won't, you know, I would love to hear about health and fitness. So absolutely, I have no problem signing up. And it's a friend, and you want to help them out. So if you do it right and just kind of put it out there on Facebook and say, hey, you know, I'm really excited about this, and if anybody would like to, you know, join my newsletter, this is what I'm offering. And they can always unsubscribe. I would rather do it that way than to go after my family and my friends, per se. My Facebook has more than just my close friends and relatives, so it's not a problem if I were to do something like this. But, you know, sometimes we ask a lot of our family and friends, so I think asking a bunch of Facebook friends wouldn't be a bad thing. They want to help you, and they want to see you be successful. So that's all I have, 6 proven ways to build your email list. I will get those videos on the end. You can see them now, actually. And make sure you check out the links below from some of those different things that we talked about. The autoresponder, ClickFunnels, and solo ads are all down there if you're interested. And please subscribe. I'm so close to being able to apply to be monetized with YouTube. I'm really excited. If you like watching my videos, watch them lots and lots right now for me so I can get that watch time up, and subscribe or ask your friends to subscribe. I put out a video every day of the week except Sunday. And I just, my heart is, my passion is to help you build your business. And I want you to not waste time trying to figure out what you have to do and waste a lot of money, because it can happen to new people. They're not sure what to do, what tools to buy, and then you end up spending a lot of money and getting nowhere. And I promise you, I will never lead you astray. So again, don't forget to subscribe, and thank you so much for watching the video, and I'll see you on the next one.